The fun thing about Tacticus PvP events is, well, there's many fun things, but one of the best things about them is obviously when receiving your crates. Thing is, every time you open a crate, it does feel like they're kind of spring-loaded with Maladus shards. And the moment you open them, it propels the shards up into your eyes, so you screaming as they do so. Use me, use me, use me! Maybe that's just me. But yeah, that's why I've got Maladus one star rare. Simply because, as you can see, I've got a lot of shards. They want you to have the shards to Maladus, they really do. And so it is, I decided it was time to do a showcase for him. Maladus has a rep. It's not necessarily a positive one. But yeah, let's see. Does he have utility? Does Maladus have anything to offer, or is he just a little bit of an also-ran? Let's have a look. First, listen to this. Enjoy the jolly jingle jangle of those flails. It's reminds me of Jingle Bells. It's like, so he's almost like Santa if Santa came at Christmas, but instead of presents in your stocking, he brought syphilis. That would be kind of the sort of thing that Maladus would do. But let's check him out. You see, he's a jolly old guy in his Terminator armor. He's got a nice little cape thing hanging here for no particular reason that I can tell. He's got his shiny jingle jangle sensor flail thing, and yeah, he's got a tail, possibly two tails actually. I think one is a dripping, oozing appendage of a cable of some kind, but yeah, this is definitely a tail. So that's look, it even wiggles when he hits people. So that's unexpected. So yeah, enough of looking at his rear, let's look at the front of him. You can see he's got a big grin there. He's a man who enjoys his work. He enjoys his work. As a member of the Death Guard, he is, of course, resilient. So, yeah, you think you've taken him out? Nah, he'll just cling on for one more turn. Yeah, yeah, calm down, just to be annoying. He has the contagions of Nurgle, just the same as every other one. So, obviously, as the longer it goes, the further the aura spreads, and more units will be affected by the temporary armor reduction. Bear in mind, of course, that if you've got him as part of a mixed team, your own troops will be affected by this, I'm pretty sure. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Sorry. Okay, so yeah. What can you say about him? Again, he's slow. Movement 2, he hits with power strikes. Each attack causes 3 hits, which I guess makes sense because he appears to have 3 flails. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, he's got 3 there, so it makes sense. Each one hits once. No range, once again. 40% pierce ratio, that's respectable. But yeah, he's all right there as far as getting into close combat is concerned. But again, the issue is actually getting him into close combat, because he's super slow. So if you're going to run him, again, you need Corrodius, really. Like, you can't run a viable Death Guard lineup without Corrodius. I mean, whether or not you can run a viable Death Guard lineup is another question that I'm not going to cover. But in any case, you need the movement boost however you can get it, because otherwise he's not going to be getting to your enemies in any great rush. So yeah, he's got decent health, his armor, well, I've barely upgraded him, barely done anything with his armor. As you can see, he's sitting at stone rank 3, and the only reason he's as high as stone rank 3 is because the upgrades were available, and I was just trying to push my power level higher. So yeah, he's got the potential there. Once he's upgraded properly, he'd be a bit of a tank, be a proper unit, proper boy, just waddling forward, jingle jangling, singing about Nurgle's gifts and whatever jolly stuff he sings about, and yeah, just causing spreading joy and misery wherever he goes, depending on your point of view about Nurgle. So yeah, it's slow, no range. Let's look at his abilities. The Haze of Corruption. So anytime he defeats his target, any leftover damage and an additional amount of power damage is dealt to a random enemy unit adjacent to both Maladus Phlegmor or Phlegmor. I'm not sure how to pronounce that. It's Phlegmor. Again, Very unfortunate name. Like, who are naming these Death Guard kids? You know, you got to... I think Child Protective Services should be... Social Services should be going and asking them some questions. You know, what is going on with your naming choices? Come on now. But yes, so... In any case, any leftover damage and an additional 10 is dealt to a random enemy unit adjacent to both Maladus and the initial target. Both Maladus and the initial target. If this unit is also defeated, an additional unit adjacent to both Maladus and its initial target is also hit. So basically, the best way to think about this is you've pushed forward, you've got enemy, enemy, enemy in three. He hits the one in the middle. Hits the one in the middle, and then the residual damage is belted to one on the left or the right. If that one dies, then a little bit more damage gets belted to the remaining one. If he's surrounded, for instance, with summons, potentially you could do a lot of hits, but not necessarily gonna kill more than three at the most, I don't think. But yeah, again, obviously, the more you push in, the more it's updated. I'm just gonna upgrade it once, just because I can, and also to get it to an even number. So yeah, he'll now do 11 damage. Exciting. Now this does tie on in with his active. The Flail Swing performs a melee attack dealing 3 times 113 to 129 at this level to the target, and it triggers Haze of Corruption if the target is defeated. So yeah, his passive in question, if you do kill a unit, it triggers the Haze of Corruption. It will trigger the overkill. So the melee attack does big damage, and any leftover damage will trigger Haze of Corruption and hit adjacent enemies. So in combination, this is pretty effective, the active and the passive going together there. But obviously, you can only do that once. Any unit defeated is automatically overkilled. So yeah, it will stop anything coming back. Yeah, there you go. So Flail Swing, he comes in. Jingle jangle, does big active damage, the passive kicks in, does a little bit more damage as well. So yeah, that's Maladus. What more can you say, really? I mean, I'm going to give him a test in a minute, just so you can see it in action, see if we can get some utility out of him. But what can he be used for? Not a lot, really. I mean, if you've got him and really strong and you want to run him, great. But to be honest, there are so many better units. Like, he's slow. As I say, his active and passive combo is effective, but only works once. His passive is okay. His Haze of Corruption, or whatever it's called, not his Haze of Corruption, his Contagions, his Aura. Other Death Guard units have it, and other Death Guard units are more useful. As far as ranking the Death Guard units, I'd place him probably at the bottom with Postillion. I know I have had disagreement in my Postillion showcase video, hint, go watch that, that Postillion could actually be useful, but I don't know, I'm not convinced. Postillion and Maladus are tied at the bottom here as far as I'm concerned, with Typhus maybe just above them. But yeah, so you would not run him in PvP. If you're running a meme all Death Guard team, sure, go nuts, but you're not going to win any games. Or at least certainly not going to win a lot of them. Unless you're facing somebody who really doesn't know what they're doing, or possibly that their phone has been taken over by a cat. You might get a victory then, and even though it's not really guaranteed. So yeah, Arena, sure, it would do all right against the AI, I think. But again, you've got so many better choices. Onslaught, probably be good, but again, why would you take him? Guild Raid wouldn't even bother, he'd take forever to get to the boss, and won't do very much. Could be useful for taking out summons, but again, so many better units are available that could fill that function. Salvage Run, why would you fucking bother running Death Guard on Salvage Run? Because it's just so slow, and you want to be nipping about collecting all the stuff, so you want a little bit of speed in your Chaos Salvage Run team. And a Death Guard do not provide that. So yeah, not a lot of use for him, really. But we're going to give him a playtest anyway. And what better time to do it? With Corodius' quest. So yeah, this video is probably going to get uploaded about a week after Corodius' quest has ended anyway. So you get to see how it worked. I had one in particular in mind for this. It's like particularly the very first encounter. And the conditions for this one are no ranged attacks, and you're not allowed to take damage. So it's a bit of an awkward one. But I thought, why not? Let's give it a shot. So no ranged attacks. Obviously, Volk is straight out of there. Put this guy in here. You cannot take damage. So I thought, why not give this guy a try? So, bear in mind, of course, that Corrodius, he grants you a plus one movement boost to nearby units. But he, of course, does not have that himself. So he makes you guys faster while he's waddling behind you. It's endearing. It's endearing, I'm sure. But so we're going to start off, and we're going to push in right now. We're going to get him over there. Jingle jangle. And we're going to get him to use his active to hit the flayed one. Impressive, wasn't it? Yeah, he just gets in there. And yeah. Just didn't really achieve much of anything there, did he? And I don't think this is going to work out at all well now. So I'm going to go in here, do what I can, but we're not going to get the full marks at all. In we go again, jingle jangle. Okay, so he's done some damage. He's got the hit in, and yeah, Harkon with his overkill was much more useful there. Didn't even get the full marks. Took some damage. Wasn't inside the lightning victory. I think that kind of summons Maladus up. I got his had his abilities there. He couldn't really do much of anything. So yeah, we got some stuff coming up there. I'm gonna click on that in a minute. But yeah, as I say, that's him. I mean, there's a reason I held off doing this character showcase for a while. Like, what can you say? I don't really see much use to him, and to be honest, I'm hoping that the PvP crates start giving you shards for other characters, because there's not really any circumstance in which I can see myself running Maladus except as part of a meme deck, you know, because I just don't think he's very good. And yeah, sorry if you're a Maladus fanboy or fangirl, but that would be my opinion there, and I've got to stick by it. He is one of the worst characters in the game, I think. But yeah, you may disagree. Let me know in the comments below if you disagree or whether you think I'm right on point with my comments about Maladus, the unloved stepchild of the Death Guard. But yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this. If you have enjoyed this character showcase, feel free to check out my other ones. I've done Pastillion. I've done Corrodius, going back a bit. I've done Morven Vaal. That's quite a few. Most characters have been done. I've done a preview for Ithana, which should be up by the time you're watching this. So if you haven't watched Ithana preview already, go check that one out. And yeah, just let me know what you think about my character showcase. All right, thank you for watching. See you next time.